In 2008, Oregon decided to expand its Medicaid program to include low-income adults. About 90,000 people signed up for this program, but unfortunately, the state did not have enough money to give everybody participation into the program. So what did they do? Well, they used a lottery to allocate some people to having Medicaid and some people not. And fortunately for us, this provided a great opportunity to do an experiment to learn about the effects of having Medicaid health insurance on various outcomes like cholesterol, blood pressure, depression, etc. So over here we have the data for the study design. Here at the top, we have about 90,000 people who submitted their name for the lottery. These are the people who wanted Medicaid. Okay? Among these people, we excluded about 15,000 of them for various reasons, like they actually don't live in Oregon. Okay? So putting aside those people, there's about 75,000 left who qualify for Medicaid in Oregon. Okay? Among these people, we don't have enough money to give all of them Medicaid, so we split them randomly into two groups. The treatment group, about 30,000 people actually get Medicaid, and about 45,000 people don't. Okay? Among these people, the researchers then came in and surveyed people later on, a year later, after they've had insurance for a year, and asked them questions like, what's their blood pressure, etc., and measured these variables after having insurance for a year. So at that point, among these 30,000 people, they surveyed about one-third of them. So 10,000 were chosen to gather data on. Among the controls, about another 10,000 were chosen to gather data on. Okay? So let's look over here at the treatment group. These are the people who have insurance. Among the people who were surveyed, only about 6,400 actually responded, okay, giving us a survey response rate of 73%. So there's the first problem that happens in real life with doing an experiment. Even though we randomly assigned some people to have Medicaid and some people not, we weren't actually able to get data on about 30% of them. So there's some missing data, and that's a problem we'll have to deal with, and we'll talk about later. Now, the second really big problem with experiments in practice is some people, you see, among these people who we have data on from our survey, among these 6,400, only about 2,000 are enrolled in the Oregon Health Plan. Okay, that means only about 2,000 actually signed up for Medicaid, even though the government said you can have free Medicaid. Another 4,500 are not enrolled in the Oregon Health Plan, okay? So among the people we have data on, we have 1,903 people who are enrolled, over 1,903 plus 4,484, and that's about 30%. So only about 30% of people in the treatment group actually received treatment. The remainder 70% are called non-compliers because they were assigned to get Medicaid, but they just didn't sign up. They did not comply with their assigned treatment. Okay, and that's a big problem for learning about treatment effects in experiments. So in the next module, we'll talk about how do we deal with these non-compliers.